Good morning, everyone. So how are you today? Okay, very good. So before we start our class, today we're going to have a short prayer. Okay, so Alex, please lead the prayer. Everybody, please stand up. Amen. Thank you so much, Alex. You may all sit down. Alright, so we're going to check your attendance. As I call on your name, please say present. Okay, so Donna, here. Very good. Marjan, here. Okay. Joanna and Alex. Okay, very good. Everyone is here, so everybody is present. Very good. We're going to set our house rules. So our house rules is always put your cell phone on silent mode. Second is no eating inside the classroom. And participate during class discussion. Lastly, clean as you go. Okay, so please settle down. Make yourself comfortable. Sit straight, okay? Alright, so we're going to have a review regarding our lesson yesterday. So who among you here still remember the things or the best practices that we need to do when handling customers' complaints? Alright, so Merjan. Okay, very good. So first is active listening. And then empathize with the customer. Provide appropriate resolution and escalate the issue to the higher authority if needed. Okay, so why we need to do an active listening? Okay, Donna. Okay, very good. Well, we need to do active listening. We need to practice active listening because we need to listen to the customer first about their complaints or query, okay? So that we can provide appropriate resolution and then we can empathize with the customer. Empathize means that you're putting yourself on customer's shoe. You let them feel that they care about, you care about them, okay? And then if you cannot resolve the issue, what you're going to do is escalate the issue to the higher authority. That will be your supervisor, okay? Alright, so let's move on. I want to show you three pictures here. So can you please tell me, Alex, the first picture, what can you say about the first picture? Okay, so yes, there is a guy or a boy taking call. Yeah, you can see a different app. Very good. What kind of app? The first one there with a telephone. Okay, very good. So Viber. Next is, yes, a mobile phone with data, mobile data. Third, it seems like a customer is doing a video call. Okay, you can see also there the Facebook messaging, just like an email, and then the Twitter. Okay, how about the second picture? Okay, Alex. Pretty good. So there's a guy and a girl and a lady taking calls, and what they're doing aside from taking calls. Oh, okay, very good. So the girl is smiling. Okay, we always remember, I'm always reminding you guys that every time we take calls, we need to put a smile on every call because it will change the mood of the customer as well as their tone of voice. Very good. And the last picture, the third one at the bottom. Okay, there's a little tall lady taking calls. So what do you think she's doing aside from taking calls? What else? Okay, you can see there that there is a statement. First one is use computer program like Microsoft Office, email, and other chat technologies. So those are the things that call center always use to communicate with the customer aside from receiving their calls. Most especially through doing chat and email support, okay? So the next is able to explain the company's industry, okay? I believe that the customer is asking some inquiries about the products and services that the company is offering to the clients or subscriber. Okay, so let's move on. So, looking at the picture, so what do you think our lesson for today? Okay, take like an inbound and outbound call, okay? Alright, so at the end of this module, you are expected to address customers' inquiries, concerns. Second is provide courtesy to the customers in accordance with customer relationship management. And lastly, establish rapport in accordance with customer-client relationship. Alright, so we're going to do an activity, a short activity. Put your answer here. I'll just give you 5 minutes to answer. So just only 5 set of questions. So you will going to tell or determine if the customer is happy or not according to the statement. So go. Okay. So you can start now. Okay, time is up. Exchange your paper and your seatmates. Okay. So first, they keep coming back for more. So what do you think customers are feeling? Is he or are they happy or not? Donna? Okay, very good. So the customer is happy because they're coming back for more. That means they are satisfied with your service or your product. Second is they convince their friends to buy your products. Okay, very good. Happy as well because they are encouraging and inviting more people to buy your products, especially your friends. Third is they leave nice reviews. Okay, very good. Happy as well because if they leave a nice review, that means they are happy with the product and services of that your company is offering. They follow your social media channel closely. Happy as well. Very good because they are interested with your company. And then lastly, they show appreciation. Very good. So most of the time, if they show appreciation on the product and services they're giving is what? They're glad and very happy with your company. Okay, very good. So we got 5. Okay, very good. Everybody got 5. Perfect. I'll give you 5 around the 5 left. Okay, very good. So this is just only an activity, but I'm going to collect this as my reference if someone got low score. Okay, so let's move on. Okay, so today we're going to talk about satisfied customer. This is in relation with the main topic today. So the life of a call center firm revolves around the extremely essential player. That would be the satisfied customer. So when you say satisfied customer, okay, looking at the picture here, it says a satisfied customer is the best business strategy of all. Why? Okay, this explains, first and foremost goal is to leave a good impression on the part of your customer. Therefore, you have to do your best and deal with their needs in the most accurate, fast, and courteous way possible. Correct. You need to treat the customer nicely, politely, and you should let them feel that they are very being valued. Okay. So, satisfied customer is a loyal customer. Okay. So, means the loyal customer, they keep coming back. So that will be business. The best business strategy. Alright? So this one, customer service is not just about answering calls or emails. It is a complete experience from the welcome greetings down to the parting words that leave a mark on the customer. Whatever this means. Okay. So once the customer enters your store, just like an example, you need to greet them and be happy because of their presence. That means if there's a customer, there's a possible sales. Okay, so every contact we have with the customer influences whether or not they'll come back. Okay, we have to greet every time or we lose them. We have to be great every time or we lose them. That's a correct notion when it comes to customer service. Okay, customer needs to have a complete experience, okay, from before sales and after sales. Okay, so next, there are two types of in bank calls errors. So, first one is handling queries. Queries are questions or inquiries which may start from a very simple request relating to facts and figures to very complex queries regarding policy matters. The call center staff needs to be well-rounded on both facts and figures, as well as the policies and guidelines to address the concerns. Okay, so looking at the picture, a call center employs agents who act as representatives of their clients' behalf to deal with the questions, concerns, and complaints of the customer. So the best example is the billing call. Normally, the customer asks question about their bill. So most of them asking why they have an extra charge on this particular month. So the customer service should answer it accurately or correctly, because the customer needs to know what kind of extra charge that they incurred on their bill on that particular month, so that they will understand how they got the like, for example, they're paying $100 only every month, but they on that particular month they got $110, so there's a $10 extra charge. So I need to explain thoroughly to the customer so that she will not get a rate. Okay, so you need to also advise customer about the due date and how much they owe to the company, okay? But in a nice way, so that the customer will not get offended, most especially if the customer is a good payer, right? So an agent, that's an agent responsibility. Okay, so second is handling transactions. So the call center staff would have to utilize a complex front-end system to record these transactions. This may involve entering details on how the call screens to complete the transactions. So the focus in this type of call is more on procedural knowledge. There are specific steps required to complete a given transaction using computer systems provided. So again, I'm going to give you an example about the billing call. Okay, so on this particular scenario, customer would like to pay their bill. Okay, so customer would like to say, I'm going to pay my bill, or I'll be using credit card. So the customer is going to verify if he is an account holder or she is an authorized person in the account. And then since the customer proactively said that she was going to use her credit card, so you're going to ask what's the account number, how much you're going to pay, and then advise the customer that you're processing the payment and taking out that particular amount on your credit card. Once the process successfully done, you need to advise customer I have successfully processed your payment. The amount of $100 have been deducted to your credit card, and it will show on your account. Okay, so you can see here there's a different way. I'm helping customers, so different transactions. So it depends on the customer company services and products that's offering. Okay. Sometimes there are companies that are doing both, handling inquiries and handling transactions. So many call centers handle both queries and transactions. Appropriate resources and effective information must be provided to support this kind of complex environment. So on my own experience, I also handle both. I do inbound calls at the same time, outbound calls. So I do collect money. Doing collection, credit and collection, that's the outbound call. At the same time, doing an inbound call, receiving inquiries from the customer. Alright, so that's possible. I'm just doing that in a day. For more than a year. Okay, so that is a handling blended calls, inbound and outbound call. Okay, so next is we need to gather information in a courteous and professional manner. Okay. So first we need to do is we give the customer prompts and greetings. So greet the customer politely. Yes, it's very important that you greet the customer, good morning, something like that. Hi, ma'am, good morning. And then you need to speak clearly and introduce the department or family. This is Michelle calling from E&L company. I am from technical support or from credit and collection support. I would like to speak with Miss Amber if you're doing the outbound call. But if you're doing the inbound call, coax cable because customer doesn't know what is coax cable. Okay, because that's a technical term that you use in your department. Okay, so like this one, don't say just say, don't say, can I help you? So it says, the key is to promote a natural conversation that makes the customer feel welcome and relaxed. So natural way is like, hi, good morning, ma'am. Okay, so how are you today? Something like that. Okay, next, manner of the conversation. So be nice and courteous. Express gratitude for completing a functional task whenever necessary. Offer appreciation when the customer completes a revenue-generating transaction. So, for example, if you're from technical support, there are times that you will going to ask the customer to, can you please unplug your modem? So, if the customer, if your request, if the customer obey your request, then you need to thank the customer for doing that, okay? And then offer appreciation when the customer completes a revenue. Like for example, if the customer bought something from your company, so thank you for buying and thank you for award for more transactions, something like that. Okay, so show your, you recognize your customer. People enjoy recognition. It will make them feel to return. Like for example, oh, hi there, it's you again, something like that. Okay, appreciate their presence. Next, confirm messages. Okay, so it should only be presented when confirming critical entries such as making payment, transferring funds, or updating account information. So when you say that, like for example, if the customer would like to pay using their debit or credit card, so you need to verify with the customer, like for example, I would like to confirm your credit card number is blah 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 blah, and the amount I will buy to debit from your credit card is, what I mentioned, is $100. Is that correct? So, okay, if the customer confirmed, then go ahead, process the payment. And then, updating the account information. Example, customer changed their phone number, so you need to verify your phone number has been changed from 0 blah 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 to 02 blah blah. Okay, so that the customer can confirm and you got that you got the correct information. Okay, so ask question, the more specific details you get from what the customer is looking for, the better you can satisfy their needs. So like for example, may I know what you're looking for? Are you looking for coffee with sugar or coffee with something like that? So it's just gathering specific information so that you will know what the customer is looking for. Okay, so redundancy, when you say redundancy, okay, it's that doesn't mean the regular redundancy that we used to. Okay, it has a different meaning when it comes to call centers. So redundancy is an IVR channel should always available, especially during emergencies, to provide backup plan. So here's our plan in case of disaster. You can sell it to the customer. So like for example, it's an outage that happened. So so if a particular site has a problem with the power outage or there is a disaster typhoon that damaged the site, then the contingency plan, all the other site will going to take the call from the particular site that has been affected by particular disaster. Okay, so and then make sure that the customer do have easy access to reach the correct department. Okay, so that they will not get irritated by hearing an automated messaging. Okay, so guys, like a backup plan. Okay, so very important, security. So safeguard customers' data. So it's a data privacy. Nowadays, there are a lot of people phishing information, like as pretending to be the account holder, but they're not, just only getting the information from the customer service of the customer. Okay, so, it's something like scamming the customer, and they will going to use, once they got the information from the customer's account, they will use it on scamming, like buying products online, something like that. So you need to make sure that you authenticate the account, especially if someone is calling from for a customer, make sure that they are an authorized person on the account or really do not talk with her. Okay? Alright. So, next, number clarification is also important when it comes to taking customers' card number. Okay, so convert the numbers in logical groups, 4x4 for 16-digit card numbers, and 334 for the phone numbers. So, for example, this is the example. So, 314, you need to give the information to the customer by 4 so that it will be easier for them to jot down if they're writing it down on the notes. Okay, so 3141, POS, 5926, POS, 5358, POS, 9793. Okay, for the phone number, you need to give the area code. So, like, for example, 034 area code. Phone number is 445-4881. Okay, so it's very important that you use this so that to avoid lengthy conversation. Alright, next is menu structure. Okay, limit the menu items to 5 or less options. It helps customers efficiently and effectively complete their intended goals. Okay, so avoid the use of return to the main menu option. Looking at the picture, that's the correct process. For example, customer is calling, then call answered by IVR system, so interactive voice response. So for example, if you have a problem with your bill, please select option 1. If you have a problem with technical issue or technical support, press option 2. Same goes with the sales and other inquiries. Okay, so option 1, option 2, that's better to filter the call. Okay, so same goes with number messages. It applies to those who are company or department that's not working 24 hours on production. So it's something like a voicemail greeting or an automated voice messaging system. So automated voice messaging system. So looking at the picture here, it says thank you for calling AML. Our normal office hours are 8 p.m. to, example, 5 p.m. Monday through Friday. Please call back during our normal office hours to any non-urgent or general office-related inquiries. However, if you have an emergency or need urgent assistance, please press 0 now to speak with a live agent. So, thank you. So, the call will be forwarded if you need an emergency. So, it will be forwarded to the credit department. Right? So especially on the credit card. If you use your credit card by the middle of the night, then you need to call the 1-800 hotline, then advise the customer service that you use your credit card and need to block it, okay? And then, accuracy. So, have an accurate and up-to-date information available to your callers at all times. Why we need to give an accurate information to your customer? Simply because to avoid customer calling back again. So, if you can't give correct information to customer, that's so possible. They were going to ask or call your hotline, ask the same question because the one that you provided is incorrect. Okay, so let's avoid that. And it's a big moment. Be objective and business-like at all times. So deal with your matters in a professional manner. Avoid injecting personal feelings. Don't take it personally. Okay, so deal with the matters in a professional manner. But do not get angry with the customer. If the customer is shouting, so let be it. Let them vent what they feel. Because sometimes customers just only frustrated. They just want to vent their emotions because they were waiting on the line for about an hour or two. Okay, so it's normal in the call center, most especially if the account is sick. It has a problematic technical issue. Okay, so avoid injecting personal feelings. Like, do not engage on political and religious conversation. It's a big no-no as well. Just tendency of going to clash. Alright, so don't take it personally. As Marip said, don't take it personally if the customer is angry. Just angry. They're just mad, not with you, but with the company and the process of your company. Alright, so SMART means specific, measurable, attainable, relevant, and time-based. So, That's very important that you remember that during every time you take taking calls. So I want to show you a short video here. Okay, hold on. It's still loading. So this video is all about taking information from the customer. So this lady is
W-R-I-G-H-T.
Okay, Mr. Wright. I'll try and lead you through. I'm afraid the line's engaged. Would you like to hold it?
Can I leave a message?
Certainly.
Could you please tell Mr. Morgan our latest shipment has been delayed and that there are 300 dresses here should arrive next Friday?
Dress order delayed. Arriving next Friday.
Yes, and would you please ask him to give me a call as soon as the shipment arrives?
Of course. Could you let me have your number, please?
Yes, it's 01632-960-994.
That's 01632-960-994.
Yes, that's right. Thanks for your help. Goodbye.
Goodbye.
Okay, so what did you say about the video? So I mentioned earlier, this lady is a receptionist. So she filters the call, she answers the call, but she filters the call where the department needs the call needs to go to put through. Okay, since the person that John is trying to call is not available, so this receptionist just asks the information from John, get information from him. So that he will going to course through, or she will going to give it to the person that the call is intended to. Okay, so that's what you do if the customer is not available. Alright, so we will going to talk about call structure, but that's the next topic. I want to show you a video with me and Pia. Sorry for the title, it should be billing call. Alright, so let's play.
Hi, thank you for calling for our company. This is Pia. How may I help you? I'd be happy to pull up your account now and check the billing details for you. Could I have your account number together with your first and last name, please?
Sure, it's 123845 and my full name is
Jolly Mike. Thank you, Ms. Ligmayo. Just give me a few seconds to pull up your account. It was for the month of February this year, right?
Yes, that's right.
Okay. I have your account pulled up now, and I'm only seeing a $30 charge here for the month of February this year. Could you check your bill and review the amount?
No, that can't be right. I am literally holding my bill right now, and it says February, and it says $33 in eight gold letters. So maybe the charge was moved to June or August. I don't know. All I know is you're overcharging me, and it's written on my paper.
Yes, Ms. Ligmayo, I also checked your advance charges this year from January to February 2022. And for all of these months, you were only charged $30 each. Let me just check further though. I am seeing $33 charge here, but this was way back last year in July 2021. Would you mind checking the year of the billing paper you're holding right now? No, don't worry about it. You're fine. Welcome, Miss Stigmaya. Is there anything other I can help you with today?
No, that's okay. I'm good.
Thank you for calling Park Company. Have a good one too. Goodbye.
Alright, that's the call that we did. That's the billing call. Hold on, please. There's a technical issue here. Okay, one moment. Actually, customers got a mistake on checking on the year of the bill. You just only see the month, but not the year. Okay, that's why she called the customer service asking the explanation of the extra charge. Alright, so what Pia did on our call is she followed the call structure, so call flow process. So calls in general follow a specific sequence of actions or logical in structure, whether it is inbound or an outbound call. The agent must acquire the necessary skills in carrying out his or her job by following the protocol of the company. So the call structure goes like this. So first is opening, opening of skill or greetings. I think we're calling email. You can do this yourself. This is like, for example, Michelle. So how may I help you today? So so that the customer will know if she's calling the right company and the right department. So sometimes you need to advise, I am from technical support, so how may I help you today? Okay, so next is, so the Pia did the for the opening spiel, so she's very good at that. The second is, she's by the way, she did the opening spiel with a smile. It's a big plus on doing inbound calls. Okay, next is identifying the call purpose through listening. So that's what we do always during the second account identification as well as the customer's complaint. So you need to listen to the customer what they are saying so that you will know what you're going to do and do some probing so that you can assess the customer's issue correctly. Alright? So next is, after you hear the customer's complaint, you need to gather information that's for inbound. So ask the customers about their bill, so how much is that, when was that. So very important, Pia did if she checked the both the year, the recent year and the last year's bill of the customer. Shows that's the reason why she was able to identify and confirm that the customer is holding previous bill or last year's bill. Okay, very good with Pia. So make the fourth one is making an agreement. So just for the inbound agreement, like for example, a different example here. So, hey, customer got a problem with their internet. So it's a company's fault because there's an outage happened on the area. So customer just experienced no internet connection for 2 days. So the customer is asking for a credit. So you need to give the credit to the customer the 2 days that they weren't able to use the internet. Okay. So give them a $20 credit on their account. Customer will be happy on that. Lastly is closing spiel. Okay, so you need to take the customer. Offer first additional help. Will there be anything else that I can help you with? If not, then you need to advise customer. So thank you for calling AMO. And have a good one. Okay. So it applies on both inbound and outbound calls, but we have a different skills that we do if you do the outbound calls, maybe especially if you do sales. Okay, so here's an example for doing the inbound call. Alright, same goes at the bottom at the outbound call. So greetings, introduction, good morning, this is Diane from RRT, something like that. through listening. Customer acknowledged he started introducing himself and states the purpose of the call. So sometimes this, the number two, you can skip the one if you already did on the opening spiel. You already did that on the opening spiel. Okay, so the third one, gather information. You need the customer's information. What's your name of your name and your account numbers? I could pull the account, something like that. Have you made any transaction with your company before? So that's part of moving. You're asking further information with the customer. Okay, so stating the purpose of the call if you're doing the sales, outbound calls. Okay, you're selling something to the customer, something like that. So are you interested to buy something that our company is offering? Okay, making an agreement. As what I mentioned, you can give the customer $20 credit if the customer is asking for credit for 2 days no internet connection. Okay? So, lastly is a closing spiel. I already explained that to you earlier. So, saying goodbye, you need to ask the visual assistant first before closing in the call. Okay? So, let's do a group activity. By the way, do you have any more questions so far? Here as Crystal? Okay, very good. So let's do an activity. Okay, divide the class into four groups. Each group will have a representative or representatives to act as the customers and agencies. But what we always do, we do not calls, but this one, I'll give you a scenario. Customer would like to book a flight for Tugao for Palawan. Okay? So like as a reservation of a hotel as well as the plane ticket. So you will be given 5 minutes to practice and 5 minutes to perform the task. So group one and two will be in the front to practice, and then group three and four will be at the back, okay? Okay, so you can start now. Okay, so time is up. Very good. Group one, they got 20 points because they performed excellent. Okay, on all categories here or skills. Group two, okay, they got 20 points as well. Very good. Okay. Same goes with group three and four. Okay, very good, guys, because you practice well and then you listen to our call flow. Very good. Okay, so do an assessment here. This is just a short quiz. I wanted to get a paper and I think it's one half cross twice. Just answer 5 questions here. So select the correct, the best answer. So just write letter on your paper. I'll just give you 5 minutes. Okay, time starts now. Okay, time is up. Okay, please exchange paper and your seatmates. We're going to check your paper. Okay, so here's the answer. So we got correct on the number one. Okay, it's a very good Donna. Okay, who else? Okay, that's good, Alex. Now, how about number two? Accuracy. Very good. Number three, four, and number five. So who got perfect? Perfect score. Okay, everyone got a perfect score. Very good. Okay, so I believe that everybody understand our lesson because all of you got perfect on our assessment. So very good, that's a nice one. So before we end our class, I'm going to give you an assignment. So for you can write it on a whole sheet of paper. So first thing in the morning, you'll get to pass it. Okay? Alright. I'll leave this message, this code, The best advertising is done by satisfied customer. We already discussed that on the set of our discussion. Because a satisfied customer is a loyal customer. We will keep coming back to buy your products. Alright? So that's the end of our topic. Thank you very much. So please pick up pieces of paper. Okay. Thank you, class. Thank you and goodbye.